Hello friends, good morning. In this lecture, I will explain how the relay acts as a comparator. In my first lecture, I had given you the definition of the relay. The definition is, a relay is a device which detects the abnormal condition in power system by constantly measuring certain electrical quantities which are different during fault condition. So relay basically acts as a measuring device and comparing device. So it performs the function of measurement and then it compares the operating quantity with certain difference, because this operating quantity changes during fault condition. Therefore, relay is nothing but a comparator. Now, comparators are basically of three types as far as number of actuating quantities or number of quantities are concerned. Number one is single actuating quantity. Second, double actuating quantity, and third, multiple actuating quantities. Let us start with the comparator with single actuating quantity. So in this single actuating quantity comparator, the operating condition is S operating. This is operating quantity. This is restraining quantity or reference quantity. The operating condition may be like this. Operating quantity should be less than restraining quantity, or operating quantity should be greater than the restraining quantity. If we consider this condition, then it may be under voltage or under current type, because operating quantity is less than the restraining quantity. So it is example of under voltage relay. Here it is more than the restraining quantity. So this gives the example of over current or over voltage relay. So this is nothing but a level detector. Block diagram may be like this. Here we are having a reference quantity, that is restraining quantity, and here it is operating quantity. To satisfy this condition, this should be positive, this should be negative, and when S operating is more than S restraining, we get the trip output. For this condition, this should be negative, this should be positive. So when operating quantity becomes less than the restraining quantity, we get the trip output. The advantages of this type of comparator or single actuating quantity comparator is, it is simple and cheap. The drawback is, it does not provide the directional sense. That is the biggest drawback of this single actuating quantity comparator. It does not provide the directional feature. Second is double actuating quantity comparator. Now the drawbacks of the previous, that is single actuating quantity comparator, was it does not provide the directional feature, and as it is single actuating quantity comparator, it is less reliable, reliability is poor. So both these drawbacks are overcome by the double actuating quantity relay or double actuating quantity comparator. Here there are two types. First is amplitude comparator. The operating condition may be like this. Operating quantity should be greater than restraining quantity, or operating quantity should be less than restraining quantity. Here I will change it. Now in previous case also, same operating condition I had written. But the difference is, here this S restraining is also variable. S operating, that is also variable. In previous case, S restraining was not variable. It was fixed. That is the reference. Here it is variable. So when we plot the characteristic of this type of comparator in complex plane, we get a circle characteristic. So radius of this circle is nothing but the restraining quantity. So this is restraining quantity. It can have any phase angle from 0 to 360 degree. And we are comparing only the amplitude, that is amplitude of the operating quantity. So if this condition is there, then if you consider the region outside this circle, then operating quantity is greater than restraining quantity. So outside this circle will be the operating region, inside this circle will be the restraining region. If you consider this condition, then operating quantity should be less than the restraining quantity. So that is the inside area of this circle. So for this condition, the operating region will be inside this circle. So that is the amplitude comparator. So example of this type of comparator is distance relay or differential relay. Next is phase comparator. Phase comparators compare only the phase angle of both these quantities, or instrument quantity and the operating quantity. And the condition is like this: phase angle, say phi 1, is less than phase angle of operating quantity with respect to the reference quantity is less than phi 2. Then the relay will operate. In complex plane, if you consider this phi 1 and this is as phi 2, then above this will be the operating region. Example is directional relay. So directional element has straight line characteristic. So if it is amplitude comparator, the characteristic is a circle. If it is phase comparator, characteristic is a straight line. If addition of these two angles is 180 degree, then it is the straight line. Otherwise, one straight line in this quadrant, one straight line in this quadrant. But both these should be straight line. Advantage of this type of comparator or this type of relay is it provides the directional feature and it is reliable. But the drawback is we cannot generate the non-conventional characteristic. Only conventional characteristics can be generated, like circle and straight line. Next is multiple actuating quantity relay or multiple actuating quantity comparator. So as the name indicates, here the number of actuating quantities are more than 2. In power system, sometimes we need the non-conventional characteristics like quadrilateral, trapezoidal, elliptical, and so on. So these characteristics cannot be generated by double actuating quantity comparator or double actuating quantity relay. So we need more than 2 quantities. So these non-conventional characteristics can be generated by more than 2 actuating quantities relays. So that is all about relay as comparator: single actuating quantity, double actuating quantity, and multiple actuating quantity. Advantage of this is non-conventional characteristics can be generated. Disadvantage: it is costly. Another advantage: it provides the directional feature and it is